cities, watch your car. Baby, you drove me to move real far.
Today.
I miss you more than the day you left. You can find another cheek. You can find another week. But you won't find anybody like me. Like me. Like me. Baby.
So excited.
I know. I'm staying on the new job.
We're going to have our own firm. I told you that.
We're going to have everything that I've dreamed of.
I won't have to take the bus anymore. Either. That's gonna be a good day.
New call.
That's gonna be a good day. Thank you. Thank you. Before I go, is this bus for you?
It's beautiful.
It's for you.
Oh, Matt. It's beautiful. Oh, I love it.
Only the best for you. Only the best.
Thank you.
Break up, then we make up again. Cause we are the fix a couple until the end. So sorry for the car, sorry for the lie. Sorry that I gambled it away.
So let him know that she's my husband.
So
got
here
this
is
one.
My heart, here is your
and
keys.
Start
here is the room, let's fix it, please. Find another chick.
These are real pearls from Indonesia.
So I'm already installed.
That's right. Like that?
That's so good.
No problem. I'll talk to you in a little bit about that. That's cool. Thanks. Hey, good morning. How are you? Welcome to Go You Therefore. I'm Pastor Malcolm. Sit anywhere you like.
Thank you. Thank you.
Come on, praise God today.
Amen.
Welcome to Go You Therefore Ministries, and I want to talk to you today about the power to reset your life.
Amen.
All of us have made some mistakes.
Yes.
And we've fallen into a dark place many times. But there's power to reset your life if you believe.
Yes.
Amen. Do you receive that today?
Yes.
Come on, give God praise. Come on, say hallelujah if you receive it. Come on, give him glory.
It's now 6 o'clock the next night. Not to mention you smell like cigarettes and cheap wine.
Come on now, come on. Do we have to do this now?
Yes, Matt, because I'm tired of being hurt and disappointed.
You know what? You don't understand.
Understand what? How you stop living, stop dreaming, stop believing?
Oh, here we go.
Huh, you about to preach at me now, right? Well, save it, because I don't want to hear it. I don't.
Matt, what happened to the dream of the life that we wanted to build? What happened to the love that we had with one another? All I do is try to be better, thinking that maybe, just maybe, it'll make you love me more. You're drinking in your depression. Matt.
Yeah.
Matt, I'm tired. I can't do this anymore. I can't. Do you think you're the only one hurting and wanting? Well, I want more, Matt. I need more. I can't sit here and die with you. As a matter of fact, you're not even dying. You're committing suicide daily. Yeah, walk out, you selfish bastard! Do you think you're the only one hurting and wanting? Well, baby, when you lost, I lost too. Nights you sat in that bathroom and cried, I laid in that bed and I cried too. I can't do this anymore. I've been on this ride all along. But now it's time for me to get off, because this bus is going express to hell. And I'll be damned if I'm on it when it gets there.
Stop, babe. Hey, stop. Stop. Stop! Does it look like I'm playing? You're still here?
Where's my money?
Get yourself cleaned up. Don't let nobody see you looking like this. Thanks, sweetie. How are you? You know, I've been calling you and texting you, and I haven't gotten a response yet. Is everything okay? Do you need anything?
Yeah, Mom, sorry. I just been working on this big project for work. So caught up.
Okay.
Hey, Ma?
Yeah, what's up?
Never mind.
How do you what, Todd?
Have faith in God.
What do you mean?
I mean with wars, people dying every day. Not to mention you and Dad losing a mortgage firm. Like, how do you get up every Sunday, go to church, and have faith in God?
Todd, what is going on? What is wrong?
It's nothing. It's just...
Todd... Do you hear me? Todd!
Yeah, Ma. Just forget it.
Todd, wait, don't leave.
Todd.
Hello.
Hello, Colleen. This is Nick from Realty Mogul Property Management. I was calling because it's the 7th of the month and we have not received your rent check yet.
I've been meaning to call you. The rent is going to be a little late this month. I'm sorry.
Colleen, I hate to have to call you on the weekend, but I work for the landlord and your rent is constantly past due. He was kind enough to give you and your husband a break on the rent and allow you to make payments on the furniture.
Again, Nick, I am sorry. Things have been rough. Look, I'm waiting for an opportunity to come through. It's going to put us back on track that we can be a little bit more consistent with our payments.
Well, listen, if I don't receive payment by the 15th of this month, I will have no choice but to begin the eviction process. But you know, business is business, okay? Have a nice day.
Okay, Nick. Goodbye.
How was your day?
It was okay.
Yeah?
Yeah. But, now that I see your smile, it's looking better. Mm-hmm. Well, you know, really today was the kind of day that really gets you thinking, you know?
Yeah. About what?
You know, I'm working for this mortgage firm, and I see how they work the system. Mm-hmm. And I was just thinking maybe, I don't know, that's silly.
Good. Come on, Matt, say it. You know I love when we dream together. So say it.
Maybe I could start my own firm. Hmm? And provide for a better life.
Well, you know, Matt, anything is possible. You just gotta believe. I mean, look at me. I never thought I would. Well.
Never what? Say it. Please.
Be in love.
Be in love? Woohoo!
What is wrong with you?
Yes, yes. Oh, baby, nothing. It's just hearing you say that you're in love with me, wow, it makes me feel like I'm a superhero. I could do anything. Truly. Colleen loves me! Colleen loves me!
Okay, now the whole city knows.
Baby, I'm ready. And I am ready. I really am. And don't you worry about a thing. I'm gonna get you everything that you want. Everything that you need. But most of all, I'm never gonna stop loving you, Colleen. Ever.
I didn't wait this long to get married to be let down this badly. I had other options. Why'd I have to choose Eric? Can't believe I'm feeling this way. I could go for a bigger size, if he could afford it. God. I can't believe I did this to myself. Why did I get married to Eric? Oh well, I guess this is marriage.
washing some uniforms before it gets out of hand. It's gonna take me a minute to go on without me, alright? Just tell Colleen I said hello.
Jeez, you could have washed these filthy uniforms from since this morning. And it reeks in here. Eric, I'm not leaving here without you. You need to get dressed.
Rube, I don't want to do this every freaking Sunday. Why are we going over there like this?
Because this is how we do, and you know that.
No, it wasn't always every Sunday, Rube. Can't she have dinner here?
No, Eric.
Colleen doesn't have to cook like that every single time. We could get it catered. She knows that.
Why are you trying to duck out again? For what? That's my mother.
You always go running back to her like a little girl.
No. You married me so I could be your mama and your personal bank account. Selfish.
This, what you're doing right now, is selfish.
Look, your opinion just doesn't even matter. If your mother wasn't such an alcoholic, you could understand a God-fearing and sober-minded mother.
That was way low. Why would you even say that?
That's the truth. I don't know why you're being so defensive.
It's not about being defensive. What does my mother have to do with anything?
Well, you cry to me about how you wish you had a better relationship with her, about how she loves the bottle so much more than you, and about all the men that she's had. So I'm just reiterating what you said. So until you can step up and start handling business and start making real decisions, like the strong man that I married, I wear the pants in this family and we're going.
So that's how you're gonna talk to me now? So now you're the man?
Make the call to the bakery. Place the order for the desserts. You can handle that, right?
I haven't seen you since the wedding.
Yeah, I've been busy. You know how it is.
Yeah, I know how it goes. Wife working on your nerves, right? Oh man, have a seat.
Thank you. Oh man, it is packed in here tonight. Let me get you a drink there.
All right, cool. I'm having...
You know, I got it.
Thanks.
Yeah, another one of these.
Thanks, Ben.
Yeah, so after your wedding, I decided to work on my own relationship, you know? It's not easy to go from bachelor to commitment in 0 seconds. So what's your story? New spot for you? I noticed some of your coworkers come here to chill after work.
Yeah, man. Crazy OT this week. And to top it off...
Well, slow down, dude. Relax.
Yeah, I should. But it's tough. Truth is, I don't even drink. Just thought I'd come here for a bite, you know?
That bad, huh? Well, trust me, that is not a good look. My pops died from that. Medical examiner said his liver was so soaked, all that liquor, you could light a match to him and burn for weeks. It's a joke.
Oh man. Hey, my wife is straight tripping. Sometimes I wonder if she even needs me. Especially since she wears the pants. She reminds me every day, like it's a song or something. Too independent for her own good. Shoot. For mine too.
Man, I am sorry to hear about those problems. It sounds like she should hang out with my wife.
You too, huh?
Oh, no, it's nothing like that. I mean, she's easygoing, beautiful, and a great cook. I know what you're thinking. She got pregnant and I married her before her family realized what was going on. Well, they eventually found out. By then, I was giving her everything she wanted. But I wasn't ready for all that emotional crap. You know, mentally I just wasn't there. I'm still trying to love her right, you know, not be that guy, blaming her for my inadequacies. We're doing our best to, you know, understand each other. It's all growing pains.
Yeah, yeah, for sure. But it's like, who do we go to? It's supposed to be them, right? That's what I thought. Dude, what's up with you, man? You know what, you're right. This isn't a good scene.
Wait, wait. All right, I'm sorry, Eric. Don't go. Okay, just have a seat, please. I mean, I know you're not trying to go home right now anyway, right? I mean, look around. Is anyone here for us? Relax. I'm totally a fan of the ladies, but sometimes their intentions don't make us feel like the star. They're quick to ruin your reputation, put you on blast as long as they look good. They pull at their testosterone to make us feel inferior, never fully loving you as a man. Truth is, I ain't never leaving my wife. But
excuse me.
Make the call, Eric. I do not want to be late.
All right, Rube. The line was busy. Calm down.
I heard you when you came in. What's up, son? How things going?
Fine, Dad.
Son, you know I love you, right? And I know we should have had this talk a long time ago. But I just didn't know how to. And I know things have been difficult with us. And even harder with me and your mom. But things are gonna get
better when you sober up, right? Right, Dad?
What do you mean by that?
I see you. And I know you. So know this. The only reason why you're even in this house is because Mom said to let her handle it. And I respect her.
Todd, watch your tone, son. I'm still your father.
Man, I used to believe that when I used to work for you. Until you started missing out on my life, putting Mom through hell. I so wanted to be just like Mr. Big Mortgage Broker. Now, you just stay broke, man.
Who are you talking to like that?
Some dream.
Huh? Who? I came in here to try to make things right with you.
You see? It's always about you. That's the problem. Listen, get it together.
Listen, I didn't come in here to argue with you, but you will respect me, even still.
Dad. I have a headache. I'm gonna try to get some sleep before everyone gets here. You wanna get things right with me? You can start by making it better for my mom.
All right, son. I can respect that. Headache, huh? I can get you something for that. And I'll be right back, okay?
Matt, you know the rent is due.
It's always due. That ain't never gonna change.
And you're right. You are right. But Matt, an eviction letter? That can change our address right on up out of here. Come on, Matt, get serious for a change.
All right, Colleen. I'm not trying to argue with you today. Let me go to the ATM. I gotta get Todd something for his headache anyway.
Wait.
Colleen, come on. Listen. Chill, all right? Do you remember where we come from? This apartment? Do you remember we came from a house?
Yes, Matt. Matt, I do. I hear this story all the time. You're always talking about what we had. Well, Matt, this is what we have. Oh, no. You're not going anywhere. We're about to have dinner in a few hours. I'll go. You know, I wish you were this eager to come with me to church this morning.
Come on, babe. Don't start that. You're better at that stuff than I am.
We used to be.
Yeah, well, that's because I had to have you.
You still don't get it. Don't you think things would have been better for us? Things used to work out for us, Matt. Don't you remember that? Matt, why do you keep trying to run away?
Shh. I'll be right back. I will. Trust me. And when I get back, maybe we'll have a little snack before everybody gets here, huh? Come here.
Okay. I wish I could live in this moment with you. But all right, Matt. Go. But right back. I'll go check on Todd. Hey. Get extra strength. That seems to work better.
Yeah, what's up?
Not much, man. Listen, our package has just been delivered.
Oh, cool. I'll meet you at the bank.
What? Are you out of your mind, dude? It's Sunday.
You call me. I got family coming over today, so I need something. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah. Listen. I got you. Look, I gotta get this out of my head. Let's go, man. Don't make me wait.
All right.
Dad, I said I have a headache.
And I said stop being so hard on your father.
Oh, hey, Mom. Can I help you with anything?
No, thank you. I don't need a taste tester. You can do that at dinner. A headache again? Boy, you in love? Your dad went to go get you something. How do you feel?
Like dying.
My God, Todd.
Mom. Why you let Dad treat you like that? Or us, for that matter. Listen. I know I'm not a kid anymore. But maybe you should just leave him. I wouldn't treat my wife like that. If I ever even have one. I love you. I take care of you when I can. Protect you. You're the best mom ever. And he can't even pattern himself after a real man like me?
Because he used to be. before he stopped living and started existing. He was a good father, husband.
That doesn't mean you keep dying every day. Mom, no disrespect to Dad, but sometimes you have to let the ones that you love see that you can let go and walk away to see if they really love you enough to come back.
Baby, and any great wife would keep on winning for her husband's sake. But I just can't stop being that because of where we are now. If I did, where would we both be? And I know you're not preaching to me. Mister, how do you have faith?
Really, Mom? All knowing, all seeing?
No, baby, I leave that part up to God. And it's up to us to work on our faith parts. And I have faith in you believing that. Okay?
I guess. I'll be up shortly. Sure you don't need any help with anything?
No, baby. You go on. Get some rest. And when you come down, we'll talk about that project that's keeping you away and when you're coming back to church. Todd. Boy, don't you play with me.
All the guilt. The guilt. But I love you.
And I love you. You need to see somebody about those headaches.
I know. I will.
Get some rest.
Hey, Mom.
Don't you hey, Mom, me. Ruby, what is taking you so long?
Talking to Eric.
You mean bullying him.
Well, you know how he can be, especially on a Sunday.
This is true. But
Eric,
I know you.
Him here. Eric, I'm not leaving here without you. You need to get dressed.
I know you were a handful growing up. But at the same time, I know you love hard. And I know you need to let up on
Eric
him.
And I are bringing dessert,
and
Mom.
And I told you not to do that.
I know, but Mom, you could have at least let us cater dinner tonight. Eric was right as far as that goes. You work too hard. So selfish.
What did you say to me, young lady? How are you and Eric really doing?
Don't try to change the focus off of me.
And thanks, we're okay.
Mom, please, let us take care of you, at least until you're able to. I mean, you know I don't mind.
But I want to make sure that you're okay. You see, the marriage thing?
Selfish?
Honey, it
this,
isn't easy.
What you're doing right now is selfish.
Yeah, everything is good. We're working and growing together, you know.
Until you can step up and start handling business and start making real decisions like the strong man that I married, I wear the pants in the family and we are going.
Doing the marriage thing.
Have you ever wondered why we have Sunday night dinner?
Well, I thought it was just traditional and I didn't want to hurt your feelings, so just went along with it.
Yeah. That's partially the reason, but for me, it's about hope. All of us. Every human being has two sides to them. The person we present to the world, acting as if everything is okay, and the person that we show to no one. The person that's hurting. Person that's broken. So Sunday night dinner is not about food. It's about hope. That someday we'll replace the person we present with the healed person of who we are. Ruby, are you all right? Do you understand? Ruby, I'm fine. Your mother is a strong woman. Where do you think you get it from? Anyway, sweetheart, listen to me. You're going to lose Eric. Once you lose a man in his mind and in his heart, then you've lost him forever. Even if he is still standing right there. It's the one thing that when he does it on his own. But when a woman cuts a man, She has to get rid of one. The premeditated thoughts and the weapon. Two, know how to clean the wound and what to clean it with. And three, then you've got to give him time so he can heal on his own. Life. Life, Ruby, just how to live. Listen, I'm not saying you should devalue yourself and accept anything. Your dad's got his hang-ups. But I never degrade him in such a way that makes him think he's nothing. Now, I'm not accepting these hang-ups. But this is where we are now, trying to work through and get rid of these things, so... Ruby?
Okay, Mom. We're getting ready.
Come on, Rube. Shake it off. Gotta get you up out of this slump. Eric is not such a bad guy.
I know, but why can't he keep a job? Why can't he treat me like a wife that has a stable husband? I just didn't expect everything to turn out this way.
Why? Come on, Rube. Think back when Dad lost the firm. Yeah, he was slumped. Well, he's still slumped. And a wreck. But even still, Mom held it together for him, herself, and for us.
Yeah, but...
And even when she's hurting and frustrating, it's God that keeps her from being a common woman and just throwing it all away to satisfy her own emotions. No matter what, she's still faithful, and she's still a loving and selfless wife.
And a great mom.
Come here, man. Get over here. Everything gonna be good.
Hey, what's going on?
Hey, buddy.
Listen, I changed my mind, and I'm good.
Really?
I'm sorry I got you out here.
Matt?
Come on now.
Matt.
I'm fine.
All right, man. Look, I'm just checking, man. But seriously, what's going on with you?
Oh, man. Now the landlord is calling on Sundays. Colleen is just about done with everything. And the last thing I need is for her to know that I'm being messy.
Well, look, man, I mean, we all go through a break, you know what I mean? Or as they would call it, an episode or even a man thing, so.
Yeah, but she would freak, man, leave me for sure if she knew what type of man thing it is.
Yeah, that's true. Look, I mean, I know she's godly and all, but, like, she looks like she could just fall down, you know what I mean?
What?
Like step into the ring, you know, go blow for blow. Oh, come on. Matt, really? Look, I'm just playing, man. Look, it's not the end of the world, okay? At least not this year it is.
Yeah, well, I gotta find some money from somewhere. This rent can't keep coming up short, you know? And it's very expensive, not knowing how you feel, what you're going through. Sam, you know a good pawn shop?
For what?
I have this tennis bracelet I got Colleen for our anniversary. And definitely should set us up temporarily till I find some way to work things out.
Don't even think about it, dude. Mm-mm. Come on. I told you I owe you. Okay? And there's plenty more where that came from. Colleen deserves that bracelet, man. You know that.
Yeah, she doesn't even know I have it. I got it for our anniversary, and I was waiting for the right time. Our anniversary is next year.
Oh, godly and high maintenance.
Nah, Sam. She's high value.
I'm sorry.
And she's my diamond. And everything that she wears has to measure up.
Indeed. You love her.
Yeah. Beyond my life.
Well, I'll tell you what. I'll hang on to this.
Maybe sell it myself. No, just kidding. Just kidding. Look, when you're ready for it, just let me know. You can call me Sam, the safety deposit box. No problem. And when you're ready for another episode, you know my number.
Thanks, man.
Thank I you. Told you, listen. No. I owe you.
Whoa, man, I gotta go. Do you need a ride somewhere?
Dude, I drove. I have my car down the street. I'm good.
All right, man.
Peace.
I'll see you later, bro.
Call me.
All righty.
Take care.
Thank you.
Hey.
Hey. You came back.
I never left you. You know, I heard you earlier. And I'm so sorry, Colleen.
No, Matt. Hey, let's just lay here. And...
Listen, hear me. I know that you've cried. And I know that you've been hurt by me. And although I've suffered a substantial loss at the firm, nothing is greater than if I lost you and the kids. I love you, Colleen.
I love you too. Matt, I just want so much more for you. For us.
No rebuttals. That's it. You've had enough rebuttals for me to get it together. And like I said, I really do love you, babe. And I heard you. But you know, it's like one day you feel like a king. And the next day, or should I say the next few years, you feel so insignificant.
Babe, I understand. I see it in your face and in your eyes. Babe, you just gotta believe. This Sunday's gonna be real special. Just wait and see. Okay. What time is it? I gotta get up. Mm-hmm. You set the table?
You want me to get the paper plates?
Mm-hmm. No. Let's break out the anniversary china.
Okay. Yeah, and if it gets any cozier, we're gonna miss all dinner. Hmm? I gotta get some water. All right. Hey, you think Rube's gonna bring dessert this time?
She is.
Yeah, and tell her don't forget the bread either.
No, Matt, I was gonna make...
Let her get it. You relax, all right? I'll be right back.
Hey, what was up with you last night? You've been hooking up with me for over 6 months now.
Listen, didn't I tell you we was done? Don't call me no more.
What's your problem? I thought you wanted this just as much as I did. Do I need to come to your house and let your wife know I'm here?
But I'm done.
Hey, Todd. How's it going, man?
It's going.
All right. It's going. For me, it's going, too. Well, if you ever need any help, I used to work in that field.
Yeah, okay.
Ooh, mercy.
Hey, Ruby Roo.
Hey.
It's good seeing you.
And you too. Feels like I haven't seen you in over a year, even if it's only been since last Sunday.
Yeah, I know. But you know how it is with our schedules.
Mm-hmm. And what are you doing working? You know Mama's gonna kill you in Jesus. In Jesus.
You are such a cool boy.
I'm gonna step outside, Rube.
Okay.
Everybody wants to step outside.
It's your problem.
We'll talk about that later. But for now, It's time to step inside.
Okay.
Call me back, okay? I know you're busy, but I really don't want to be here.
Why are you home right now?
They let me go.
They let you go? Eric, you haven't been there a year.
I know. Their contracts fell through and they had to get rid of some of us.
And how did you get picked to be part of the sum?
If I knew that, I would still be there, babe. I knew something was up when I got back from break. Listen, Rube. We'll be okay. I'm gonna find something else. I just don't know what we're gonna do right now.
Look, Eric. I'm not carrying you on my back. That's not how this works.
It works for richer, for poorer.
And poor is not an option for me. I mean, I'll see what I can do, but you need to figure this out. A man is supposed to take care of his family. I thought you had a foolproof plan of this when we got married.
This is not my plan, Rube. It will work out.
Yeah, I'm sure. Look, I'm going shopping. And don't worry, I have money.
Oh my goodness. Remind me why two grown people do that every Sunday again?
Because it's fun and it gets us through the week and it keeps us sane. It's like imagining your boss in a clown suit just to make you laugh inside.
Good point. This merger at work is killing me, Rube. It's like, just because I'm lead, they expect me to come up with everything.
Well, that's the way it works in our family. You have all the ideas. I have all the answers. Mom has the wisdom, and Dad backs it up.
But the backup has been real weak lately.
Yeah. Tried having that talk with Mom earlier. She believes that God is going to save her marriage, and I want to believe it too.
It's like ever since I left the house, there's no man left. And Dad has always been that epitome for me. A true entrepreneur, provider, father. What a real man is supposed to be. But now it's like, these days I'm like some little boy just wondering why his dad left him. And I hate that feeling. It's just not fair that this is happening.
Well, Todd, maybe Dad's been broken in a way that we're not going to understand. The firm was strongly successful and we were in a better place financially, emotionally, and spiritually.
Say amen to that.
Come on now. Hear me out. Some people believe, like, when there's a failure, that God is rejecting them. Like, they've become some type of mutation in their mind or even in our own. And that's so far from the truth.
I just don't understand why God has to work this way.
Well, it's not only how he works. It's us attempting to alter his plan to suit ourselves. Mom is doing the best that she can with the decisions that Dad is making, whether we agree with it or not. So this is where faith comes in and why it's important. And you used to tell me that too. And you're spoiled. I'm gonna go check on Eric.
You help with that too, you know.
I know. Hey. I thought you went outside.
I did.
Yeah? You okay? You didn't have to leave.
Yeah, I know, but you know I have two left feet. I know how Sundays are for you and your family.
Yeah, but Eric, you act like you're not a part of that. I mean, not even trying. You know my family loves you. Especially my mother. Come here. Well, maybe we should have stayed at home. Or at least come a little later.
Nah, we're here now.
Well, I'll try not to rush my visit.
The kids are here. Everything is good. I got the rent money for this month and next.
Matt, that's great. Hold on. What? How'd you get it?
Don't worry about that. It's legit.
Right, I'm not even gonna ask. We're gonna be all right.
Yeah.
Hey, hon.
Hey, Mom. Dad.
How you feeling, baby?
Feeling better.
Good. What are those bags?
Oh, Matt and Rue forgot to bring the groceries in the kitchen.
Well, where are they?
Talking. And thank you, Dad.
No problem, son.
Look, you know I get sometimes. And I had a pretty bad headache earlier.
Todd,
and
you don't have to do this.
But Dad, I didn't mean to disrespect you. And I wanted to apologize.
No problem, son.
Well, all right, let's see what we have here. I hope they remember the bread and the desserts.
Come on. We got this. We got this.
Well, okay, all right. I'll just go get dressed then, huh? I'll see y'all in a few.
See what's going on. I know they got some. Yeah. It's going to be good. What is going to be good?
Hello.
Hello, Mrs. Morrison?
Yes, this is she. Who's this?
This is the nurse from Dr. Riker's office. How are you?
Well, I'm good. But if you would help my curiosity as to why you're calling, that would be great.
Well, your son Todd listed you as a point of contact, just in case he couldn't be reached at his home.
Okay, well, what's going on?
I'm sorry, Mrs. Morrison, but due to patient privacy, I can't discuss that
yes,
with you.
Yes, I'm fully aware of patient privacy. I'm just a little concerned. After all, you did call me.
I do understand. Let me get you the office number.
No, there's no need.
He's here. Can you hold?
Sure.
Todd? 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 Come in.
Hey, Mom, what's up?
Dr. Reicher's office.
Hey, this is Todd.
Hello, Todd. I'm so sorry to call you today, but it's about your prescription.
Okay.
Can you come in tomorrow morning? At 9 a.m.?
Sure. But why'd you call this number?
We were unable to reach you.
My number is on file.
We were unable to reach you. I do apologize. And Dr. Riker really needs okay. to see you.
I'll be there in the morning at 9 a.m.
Great. Thank you so much. We'll see you in the morning.
Todd, what is going on?
Nothing. I'm just gonna go finish helping Dad.
No, Todd, no, it's not nothing. When a doctor's office is calling you at my house and on a Sunday, yeah, it's not nothing.
Mom, everything's okay.
Walking through.
Where's your spontaneity, Eric?
Colleen's already been waiting, babe. It's a job. I gotta take this. Go inside, I'll be right there.
All right. Finish that up tonight.
Hello?
Hey, so what's... Oh, I'm sorry, I was at the hospital. Look, I was working with a patient. There was medication and a lot of mix-up. Look, I know. I'm so sorry, but I'm here now.
Listen, man. I'm not doing this anymore.
What? What are you talking about?
Yeah, but...
Tonight was supposed to be our night to make it official.
Wrong. It's my emotions I want this thing. It takes me away from my problems, but... I've been fighting between you and my wife in my head, and that shouldn't be the case.
Where is this coming from? Look, you're just upset. I'm sorry I couldn't talk earlier, but where are you?
I know where I am.
Right, it's Sunday. Look, we'll talk again later. Just calm down, please. I'll call you later.
mom's not in here with you?
Now, we took over.
Ooh, that I'm eating out.
Really, Rube?
No, I'm just kidding.
Check the bedroom, honey.
Okay, I'll be back in a little bit.
My God, I feel like I can't do this anymore. Is this even too hard for you? My family is sick, and I don't know how to make it well. My son, what is wrong with my son? Tell me that. Please tell me. My husband, oh Lord. Is he ever gonna come out of this slump and back to our marriage? Hopefully without some whore and a baby. And Ruby, oh my baby Ruby. Lord, did I make her too proud for her own good and too confident? Or is she just that damaged and only you know about it? Lord, let Eric hold on to her so that they can make it right. Oh God, help me, Lord, help me. I feel like I'm coming apart at the seams and I just don't have hands enough to hold myself together. God. Hey, Ruby. I was waiting for you, but the guys rushed me out of the kitchen. I didn't even get to see what you and Eric brought.
Hey, Mr. Morrison.
Hey.
Hey, Todd. Where's the ladies?
In the room. Girl talking, I guess.
You think it's been years since they talked to each other?
Yeah. That's why this is so important. You know, sometimes us guys, we don't understand what the big deal is. But as long as I get to eat, shoot, it becomes as big a deal as bacon. Hmm?
All right, Mr. Morrison. Smells good.
Nah. I can't take blame for this wonderful aroma.
Yeah, save that for when he's coming out the bathroom.
Need any help?
No, we're good. Go ahead and take a load off.
No, it's cool. I'm pretty good around the kitchen.
Thank you, son, but we're good, really. Go ahead, hang out.
Okay. Just give me a holler then.
You got it.
Hey, Dad. What you think about Eric?
He's okay. Quiet, though. But not today. Why?
I don't know. I just don't know about him. It's like, where did he come from? And we're all men here. Look at that mousy thing he's doing.
Come on, Todd. Give him a break. He spoke. Other than, hello. Thank you, Mr. Morrison.
Yeah, man. That's exactly what I'm talking about. But I got it. I'll slack. For now.
There you go.
Realty Mogul, this is Nick.
Hi, Nick. Yes, it's Colleen. Hi.
What can I do for you?
I'm just calling to let you know that I have the rent, and I have next month's rent as well. You could come by this evening and pick it up if you like.
Oh? That was fast.
That was fast. Yes, Nick, that was fast. Things can change, you know.
Colleen, I'm just doing my job, but you're right. Give me a few minutes. I'll be over to pick it up real quick.
Okay, Nick. All right. I'll see you later. Bye-bye.
Mm-hmm.
Morrison.
Hello. Jessica, sweetheart, how are you?
I'm good. I've been busy, but have you seen Todd? I haven't seen him in a few days.
Well, you know Todd is here. It's Sunday.
Well, I knew he was there. I just didn't know if he was there yet.
You know, I was thinking, why don't you come over? Todd could really use the company.
No, I couldn't. I know this is his time with you and the family, and I feel like an intruder,
yes.
And...
You know, it would be great if we could see you. And it would be a nice surprise for Todd. So you'll call me when you're close?
Okay, Mrs. Morrison.
Good. I'll see you in a while. All right. Bye-bye. Lean. Let's get this dinner started. Heavenly Father, we thank you for our lives and for this meal, and for using it as a vessel to bring us together on Sundays. Lord, now I ask that you use this meal to nourish our bodies and give us strength. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
After all this, Mom, I might have to spend the night.
Hey, Mom.
And that'll be just fine, sweetheart. So, let's talk about this project. And that phone call.
Well, work is extremely exhausting. Long days, something always changing. It's like being lead, it's just salary that quadrupled hours. And another reason for most of Palmoy's work on my plate.
Well, sweetie, when are you gonna take a vacation?
Man, I wish now, but not in the middle of this project. I say at least in the next 3 months.
That's the door. I'll get it. It might be Nick.
Dad, you gonna make sure you eat your greens this week?
Yeah, okay. I promise.
You said that last week. You had a plate full of greens left back.
I'm gonna eat them this week, I promise. Thank you, Alicia. And you wanted to go out to eat? Is that what you said?
No, I was going to have
everyone. Look who came by for some of my good cooking.
Matt.
It's Melissa, remember? From the firm.
Yeah, hey. You temp for a week, right?
6 months, Mr. Morrison.
Well, come on in, have a seat.
Thank
Plenty
you.
Of food.
Thank you, Mrs. Morrison.
Pleased to meet you.
Yeah.
So, Melissa, since you lost your job, what have you been doing with yourself?
Well, since I got laid off, I work for myself. I contract out admin work. I set my own hours there, evening, and the clients pay well.
Mm-hmm. Yes, I heard they just raised the minimum wage. I'm sure that's gonna work out very well for you.
So, how's the firm? I heard it must be super successful now. Too bad I couldn't stay once your admin came back.
Maternity leave.
Well, not exactly. We had some cutbacks. Excuse me. I'll be right back.
So, Melissa, it's funny how you just popped up here out of nowhere.
Well, I didn't have your address until I ran into Matt, so...
So you decided you were gonna come by here out of nowhere for my mom's great cooking? Or is it that my dad's been your personal chef?
Ruby!
Excuse me?
Oh, give it up, Melissa. Are you sleeping with my dad?
Ruby! Cut it out! How do you just say things
Stop
like
it.
That?
Mom, please, Mom! Don't act like you didn't see it from the time she walked in the door.
Seems like you're the one that's not sleeping with anyone. Maybe if you were, you'd be a little more relaxed.
Don't worry about me. I get mine. You don't know you get yours.
Wait, don't I know you?
You know me. Don't be stupid.
Not talking to you. I'm talking to your man. The one that's not sleeping.
Me? No, I've never met you.
Yeah, you have. I have drinks every Thursday night at the Porter Lounge downtown.
All right, just hold it, hold it. Everybody just calm down, please. Calm down.
No. Hold on, Ma. I want to hear this. How do you know my sister's great husband?
This happened. How could this happen? You know how it happened. Shut up! Shut up! Shut up! Oh, but I can't. It's all out now. But you can stop it.
Can get some answers.
About what?
Oh, don't play me for a fool.
What the hell?
Matt. Not in here. You watch your mouth. You take that back to the gutter. Now the food is getting cold. Let's eat.
I don't see why everybody's acting like they don't see what's going on here.
I said, let's eat.
Why does she say she knows you?
I don't know what she's talking about.
Then why does she seem to think differently?
Yeah, bro, what's going on? You sleeping around on my sister?
Like I said, I don't know her. Now get off my back.
Stop, you're lying! I'm sick of you! You're so damn weak!
And I'm sick of your nagging and controlling self! Walking around here acting like you got it all together!
Please, don't nobody want to hear all your complaining and crying. What you need to be doing is telling us why this chick up in here is telling you that she knows you.
Such a mistake in my life!
So that's how you feel? A mistake? Now, why don't you say what you really feel?
Now, since you're the boss and speak for me any other time, why don't you say how I feel? You say it! Say it!
Calm down! You need to bring it down.
And you need to stay out of my family's business for once.
And if I don't?
Melissa, do you mind? Could you please wait outside? I'm sorry, we need to gather ourselves.
Maybe I should just leave.
No, because I think you have something to share. And where do you think you're going?
To walk her out.
Oh, no, you're not. You have a seat. All of you. Calm down and sit down. I said sit down!
Call 911! Call 911!
Todd, baby! Lord!
Fine.
Please, what's going on? Jesus, help us.
Yeah, my brother passed out and he's not responding. 332 Rigor Row, apartment 1. Hurry, please.
Oh, God. Say something. Speak to me. Todd.
Is everybody standing up for me?
Calm down, baby. Ambulance is on the way.
What happened?
Stay still. Please, Todd, rest.
Sir, what's your name? Do you know where you are?
Yes, I'm fine.
fine.
Are you taking any medication?
This fell out of his pocket when he passed out.
How long have you been taking Afinitor?
Todd, what is going on? Please tell us, we're your family.
I'm okay. I just lost my balance.
What is Afinitor and why is it in my son's pocket?
It's prescribed. It's used to when patients are trying to...
I have a brain tumor.
What?
Okay. Now you all know. And please don't tell me that everything's gonna be okay and that God is gonna fix it because...
Son, why didn't you tell us?
Dad, please don't try to show any pity or mercy on me today. I've cried out to you on many occasions, and you were so preoccupied with your failure that you forgot to realize that your own greatest success was in the family. And what are you still doing here?
I
thought you were told to wait outside. Well, since you're still here, my sister asked you a question. Are you and my dad sleeping together?
Hold on. Stop all this. Stop it right now. I'm tired of living this double life. And to answer your question, no. Me and Melissa have not been sleeping together. But I almost did the other night when I ran into her at the bar.
You see, Mom?
Wait. Please. Now, I don't know why she came here today. Because I told her I cannot be with her. I cannot.
I thought... What, you thought you were going to come over here, have my mom's great cooking, and then have my dad for dessert?
Wait, before you start pointing fingers, you need to be checking your man. It's crazy how karma comes back around and bites you.
Wait, hold on. Leave me out of this. I don't know you.
So what, you're sleeping with her?
No.
What's going on?
You got it all wrong, Ruby. That is your name, right? Who you need to be asking the question to, it's him.
Wait. I know you. You were at my wedding.
And from what I saw, now he's trying to marry you, man.
So what, you're gay now? Oh my God, help me.
Ruby, hold on.
Well, it's not like that.
Don't speak to my wife.
Who are you talking to like
that? What is going on? You both are married. Eric, tell me this isn't so.
No, I am not gay. Nor have I slept with this guy. But yes, all right? Yes, I've been meeting him. And even though I know it's wrong with the way things have been going at home, I've been liking the attention.
The way what things are going at home?
Ruby, please, let him speak. Ruby, sweetheart, let him talk, please.
Mrs. Morrison.
Jessica.
It's okay. What's happening?
I'm sorry I missed your calls. Todd, he blacked out.
He needs air. Is there somewhere else he can lie down?
Yes, we can go in the bedroom.
Go on, settle things. I know there's a lot going on. I'll take care of him.
Don't worry.
Who are you?
It's okay. She's his girlfriend.
Todd, do you have your doctor's phone number?
Wait, I have.
Yes, this is an emergency. I need to page Dr. Reichert. I'm an EMT. Thank you. Okay. Todd, he wants you to take two of those every 4 hours with 8 ounces of water. Okay, I'll tell him. Make sure you follow up with Dr. Reichert in the morning. Okay. Feel better.
Thank you.
I'm here for you, okay? Make sure you take everything you have to take, okay?
You stay with me for a little bit?
Mm-hmm. Of course.
Appreciate you being here.
Eric!
So now I'll take over for Todd and Ruby. Well, what's your story? And tell me this. Are you pregnant?
I could be.
Babe, come on.
Young lady, let me be clear. Ruby gets it from me. And I only ask questions twice. So again?
No. I just thought that maybe if I came here, he would acknowledge me more than being just a trick. Thought you guys were finished-ish.
Dear sweet Melissa, honey, you will never be the woman that I am, especially if you continue to live the life that you're living. But as for Matt, my husband, who still comes home to me, he will not be your trick, your treat, your husband, your lover, nothing. Not ever.
No, Mom. We are not playing fake Mom in here today.
Oh, Ruby, enough. It's not her fault. Totally. Totally.
Not her fault? Mom, what are you doing?
I'm doing what any woman should. You don't think I want to snatch this girl that has contributed to the near destruction of this family? Ruby, if I did that, it would be child abuse. And I love children. But Ruby, if I did that, where would we be?
Ruby, please. Ruby, please don't kill me.
Please shut up.
Ruby, please.
You shut up. It's not like she's your mother, right?
Ruby, wouldn't you do what it took to take care of your marriage? Wouldn't you do what it took to just save your marriage? Ruby, don't throw that away on one moment of anger. Ruby, that's not who we are. Ruby.
Ruby, please don't kill me. I'm sorry.
Let me tell you something. You are not to set foot in this house again. You are not to see my father again. Do you understand? Because your contractors would not be very pleased with your lack of professionalism in here.
Like I said, you better handle that.
How could he? As if my mom wasn't enough, he couldn't have been that worried about the firm if he was with her the whole time. For all we know, she's the reason why he lost it.
Calm down, baby. And go to the hospital tomorrow like you're supposed to.
So you're ignoring me now?
No, Todd. But you have to have more faith in your family. Things aren't always what they seem when you only see it your way. You have to let them state their case. And sometimes you have to let things play out all the way through to see what you miss. This could be your defining moment to get your faith back.
Is that the bell? I'll be right back.
No, baby, stay here, okay? I'll get it.
Why, Matt? Why? All of this because of
love you.
How did you not know that Todd was sick? How long has he been sick?
Oh, what do you care now?
Because I'm his father, Colin.
Yes, but at what cost? Did you forget that?
My God, Matt. What happened to you?
You gave yourself to her and obviously left us like this. What did we do to deserve to be treated so wrong?
Mom. Ruby, stay in your place.
Fine. I'm gonna get some air in here. You gonna be okay?
Yeah, I'll be okay. You go ahead. You have enough of your own stuff to deal with.
No, Eric. Done enough. I need some time to myself. I'm going to the car.
Ruby, please.
Eric, please stop. You made it perfectly clear that your appetite has changed. Eric, I'm tired. I mean, I know I'm a hard woman, even in times when you needed me to be soft, but did you have to bring this here, right now? Eric?
I didn't.
But you didn't love me enough to stop it from happening. Should have seen it before. You're just like my father. I should have known. I should have seen it.
What are you doing here? This is not the time for this.
Okay, I'm on duty, remember? But I do want to go talk to you and your family.
No, don't do this. I'm here with my wife, man. And right now I might be losing her. But I'm not going to continue to hurt her like that. I won't live like that. I won't live with that.
I understand. Can I please go talk to your family now?
Rube, listen. I will not let you go. I've been selfish, yes, but you are all the woman I could ever want, and he's no substitution for that. I just needed you to stop walking away and listen.
Did you use protection?
I didn't do that. I told you. I would never do that to you, Rube. Please. We need to make this right.
We do. But you need to see the doctor first, because I'm not sleeping with you until then.
This is ridiculous. So what's it gonna be, Matt? What do you need that isn't in here with me? Because I can make it happen, that there's nothing here with you for me.
Colleen, please. I'm not blaming you for my bad behavior. And I'm sorry. Look at me, please. I'm sorry that I let this get here. And Colleen, I only met her the other night when I didn't come home. And I didn't even remember that she worked at the firm.
That's no excuse for her.
Listen, babe, that's not what I'm saying. Why can't you listen to me? You talk at me, you preach at me, but you forget one thing, me. And no, it's not an excuse. I'm just trying to tell you why.
But you didn't say anything. You said nothing, Matt. Even in your pain, you said nothing. You didn't talk to me. You turned to her. To that, for what? I thought I had a husband. I knew something was going on. What do you think, I'm stupid?
What do you want me to say, huh? What?
I want you to own it, Matt. I want you to stop making me the fall wife. Stop making this family the heavy.
You don't know what it was like. You don't know how your family treats you like some impenetrable wall that shields them from everything that's rude or disruptive in this world. You don't know how I felt when I lost that firm. It broke me. You made me hate the church. You made me feel like some type of mutation that God didn't want anymore.
And you act like God couldn't fix that.
Yeah, I know he can. But you can't preach at something that you don't understand.
Listen, babe. Do you remember when I said that I would give you everything?
And I always had it in mind that we would do it together. Without you running,
didn't mean to preach at you. I just... I'm sorry, Matt. I'm sorry that I didn't acknowledge your pain. Because I was too busy looking at my own. It wasn't supposed to get to this place. What better than this?
We are, baby. You are. You
are. Hmm? Am I?
I did not sleep with that girl. I didn't. I couldn't bring myself to do that to you. Hmm? I kept thinking about what I have in you.
Matt, you can't keep trying to solve your problems like this. After all, well, this didn't solve anything. Look at us. Now we have to fight for each other. I didn't marry you for a minute. I married you forever. Do you hear what I'm saying to you?
Loud and clear.
We didn't build this family up to break it down, Matt. Now, I'm still mad at you, but I'm gonna give you an opportunity to make it up to me. And I promise, I'm gonna hear you. I'm gonna listen. And I'm gonna love you through everything.
Like this?
How could you let me walk away from what was destined to be? Strong, how could we carry on falling away and falling?
Hi.
Hi, is Miss Morrison available?
Who are you?
Can you tell a Nick is here?
Sure, come with me.
Mrs. Morrison, someone named Nick is here to see you.
Oh, it's okay. He can come in here, honey. Thank you.
You can come in. She's in the dining room.
Thank you.
Hey, Nick. How's it going?
Great.
Here's the rent.
Yeah, so I talked to the owners, and they're going to be increasing your rent. So the 2 months, Colleen, is only counting towards one. You're still late.
Wait a minute, wait a minute. I'm the man of this house. You talk to me.
Okay, well, like I was saying, the 2 months that you paid is only counting for one. You guys are still late.
Wait a minute, this...
Nah, babe, hold on. Nick, I don't think that the Hemingtons would approve of you increasing the rent without proper cause or going to court for further action. We haven't seen any late fees accrued. No statements sent to us. So the 2 months that we're paying today will stand for 2 months.
Oh, you know what? I'm sorry, okay? That was another client. So you're actually good.
Let me just have a receipt, please.
Not a problem.
And another thing, we're no longer gonna conduct business on Sundays. I'll come to the office during the week to make our payments.
Understood. Well, you know what? I gotta go.
All right.
Yeah. By the way, how do you know the Hemingtons?
They were clients of mine. I helped them with some properties overseas.
Oh, nice. They actually offered me some overseas contracts, but it's out of my league. All right. You guys have a good night.
Yeah, right.
This is crazy. I can't believe all this is happening. And my mom? My mom must be...
Todd, she's fine. She was just worried about you.
How long was I out for?
I'm not sure. The paramedics were here by the time I got here. But Todd, you've got to calm down.
I know. But wait. What are you doing here?
What? Because I wanted to surprise you, and I knew you would be here. Duh. And I wanted to do something different with you and your family.
Okay. So what my mom said earlier, she was right.
Girlfriend, I get it. She was just worried about you and she needed somebody to leave you with. And I was here.
Okay, that was it. Okay. You still didn't answer my question though.
Because I think you need to spend time with your family and get some rest.
I'm rested. Listen, I think we can skip the preliminary conversations because we're far beyond that now. So I'm just going to listen to my mom, follow my heart. So what do you say? Let's make this official and, you know, you finally be my girl.
Finally.
Yeah. You know I'm a handful. And I know some of that comes from the fact that I've been alone for so long, you know, just waiting for the right one. But I believe that you're here. So, you know, show me what it's like to have a wife.
You dreamed about all that while you were passed out?
Nah, some of it was before.
Your family's waiting for you in the living room.
And you're a part of that now. Come on, let's go.
Totally turned into someone else under the radar. You had been so hard on me, and I allowed that without stepping up. You were right.
Ruby.
Mrs. Benedict.
I apologize. Mrs. Benedict, Mr. and Mrs. Morrison, Eric. This is my fault. I saw Eric first at the bar. I approached him. I'm the one sleeping with Melissa.
Oh, hell.
What? When Eric came, I blew her off because I wanted something different. That's probably why she's upset. And yes, I am married too. But no, I didn't sleep with Eric. I just thought he was cool to hang out with, you know? Talk about married life. Problems. I now realize how being greedy can cause things to explode out of control. And you don't have to worry about me anymore. Mrs. Benedict, you have a great husband. He needs you only to keep him that way.
I know. Now I know.
Again, I'm sorry. I'll let myself out. Goodbye, Eric.
Scared me so bad.
Oh. Why? I just needed some sleep, Ma.
My God, Todd, you okay?
Yeah, I'm great, bro. Thanks.
Eric.
I tried not to let this happen. But no one protected me. I've always wanted you, Rube. Loved you. Been in love with you. But I let myself get weak. You know, you all are great people. My father. He was pretty great too. He was so great. He let his own brother molest me. Turned my mother into an alcoholic. And a prostitute. And the crazy thing is, even though she made money, there was never any food in the house for days at a time. But there was Uncle Perv with a burger in a dirty magazine. You know, I still have some of the pictures he took of me. And all my mother could do was pour beer down my throat so I would get so wasted that I might not remember. I was only 12! I never thought I would have these feelings, and I hate it. Rube, I'm not expecting you to get through this all at once. I'm not excusing myself at all. I do not have a desire to sleep with men, I promise you. Whatever you want to do, even divorce, I'm okay with it. Because I just want you to be happy. I'm so sorry, everyone.
No. I'm sorry. Sorry I wasn't there for you when you needed me to be. I've been telling everybody that they've been so selfish, and look at me, I'm the selfish one. You are my husband, and I'm sorry I made you feel anything less than that. I love you.
We all do, Eric. We are your family, son. And we are gonna love on you and stand by you, do everything that we can for you. You're not gonna keep beating yourself up like this. Do you hear me?
Selfish too, Dad. And you're not a failure. And you won't keep failing because I got your back.
Thank you, son. And I love you so much.
Love you too, man.
Go ahead, get your brother.
Come here. Hey, hey, family. I want to introduce y'all to somebody. This is my lady, Jessica.
What? Well, now, Jessica, you know that we're crazy. Do you still want to stay?
Still? Mom, you did this?
You're not the only one receiving phone calls. Come here, girl. Welcome to the family.
This is true. This is true.
Well, all right then. Let's eat. I'm starving, huh?
Wait. Let's pray.
Amen.
Okay.
Amen.
Father, we thank you for life again. We thank you for the food. We thank you for Mom believing that this will bring us closer together and build us stronger as a family. Thank you for the hands that prepared the food.
Same one. You want to do that one more time, right? The one we've been doing?